Hi everyone, welcome back to Prairie Wings Performance. I'm Merl Mayer. In this video, I want to clear up some things about an SI alternator. Okay, what is an SI alternator? Well, it's system integrated alternator. GM used for many years, 70s, 80s, but it was used on a lot of other things as well. And there are a couple different options that were available. From factory, not so much, but the aftermarket has a single wire alternator. These alternators are easy to put on anything, but why? This truck, we're gonna have underneath the hood, the alternator wiring look as close to factory as possible. That's what the customer wants. What I would like to do is talk about the options on these, whether we stick with the original style three-wire alternator or the one-wire alternator. Now, they're both internally regulated alternators, but there's some things that are different about both of them, some advantages and disadvantages of them. And I'm gonna take a multimeter and I'm gonna explain some wiring that will hopefully help you make a wise choice. But as well, I'm doing a lot of this from experience and what I've seen. I would really like it if I say something that you don't agree with that we can talk about it. So leave your comments in the below comment section, I guess we're gonna call it. And let's go take a look at the alternator under the hood. This is an 81 Chevy square body this alternator is on, and from what I understand, when the engine was put in, this alternator was replaced. So this is a new alternator on the truck, and the option that I know that this is a three-wire alternator, and there could be some confusion with that, is a three-wire, usually you see these wires on a single wire, there's usually a plug in here. Now, I can't talk to this, but from what I understand, some of the aftermarket ones, and literally, I want you to talk about it in the comments if you have experience with it. But there's a plug in here that you can remove and supposedly put the old wiring in. I'm not sure anything about that, so please leave your comments in the comments about that. But what I'd like to do is support a little bit of what I'm talking about with this alternator, and it's going to be about the wiring for the idiot light or the light in the dash and how that works. So I have a multimeter here, and I am gonna hopefully get it to sit here for us. So this multimeter, what I wanna do is on my ohm scale, I'm in the 200 ohm range. And so normally the plug, this one right here, is a wire that's gonna be sensing from this strap. And a lot of the wires went in for this wire to kind of the end of the line under the dash, but these new harnesses, they have it where the wire just senses off this lug, which I don't know if I agree with or not. Let me know what you think. This wire that goes on to this plug is the exciting wire. This is the charge lug. So if I take and I test from that to a ground, I actually have continuity to ground. Okay. So what does that mean? Well, let's take a look over on the bench. I'm hoping that I can explain this well enough that you can understand. On the alternator, we had continuity to ground. That means that we had a path to ground. Well, if I take this battery, I have a negative and a positive, and I have the negative on just a single iridescent bulb. So a single filament bulb. What I have is I know I have continuity through here. Okay, so that excite terminal had continuity to ground and it gets wired into a bulb in the dash. Okay, if I do that without the key on, I can light a light bulb. All right, so with the engine not running, my bulb is lit. As soon as that vehicle starts, that excite wire actually goes to 12 volts. So what a bulb is, and it's getting hot in my hand, so I'm gonna try and talk quicker. Anyway, I wasted a bunch of time and it's still getting hot. what is happening is I am lighting this bulb by a voltage difference of roughly 12 volts in this battery, probably a little more, and I'm gonna turn that off because I don't wanna hold that bulb anymore. If I were to take, and I take from positive to negative to light that bulb, and I take this and I put it on positive. Well, I go from the ground strap to the of here to here, and I have 12 volts on both sides. Well, it ain't gonna light. So when the engine is not turning, that terminal has continuity to ground, so therefore the light lights. When it starts, it goes to 12 volts. Well, it equals the voltage on both sides of the bulb. Yeah, I'm going to have power on both sides of this bulb. So that's how a dash light works. Now, what happens if the dash light burns out? Well, we have an issue, and I'm going to address that. Okay, what we're looking at here is this is the wiring diagram of the harness that I'm putting in the truck. It doesn't have a bulb in to show us the idiot light. So we're not going to reference that side of the diagram. But what I'm going to show you on this side is we have the red sensing wire, and then we have this excite wire, and it comes over here. And inside the vehicle, this then gets wired to the bulb in the dash. And that this side with the vehicle not turning would represent the ground to the bulb. And then the other wire on the other side of the bulb would be a keyed wire. And we won't dig into that, but I'll show you on this harness down here. I have the brown wire that is going to be coming into the vehicle, and it is right here. So this comes into the vehicle and it goes into the harness, and it actually ties into one of these wires here, but it goes through the light. So if the bulb burns out, that means that I am not going to have enough resistance to turn the alternator on and start charging. Does that seem a little strange? Yeah, it does. So what GM did is they put a wire like this in that harness. So the wire to the light bulb is wired from the brown wire coming underneath the hood, goes through the bulb, and gets tied into one of these keyed ignition wires. And they also take that brown wire and they double it up with a wire like this. So this wire is a special wire. And it's kind of hard to find the information on this if you're looking. I guess you'd have to dig pretty hard. But this wire usually is around 10 ohms. So it has continuity, but it has resistance in it so that it doesn't just burn up. And if I take a look, I don't have a good connection here. I guess I'll fight with this until I do. So we got, this one is about 11.8 ohms. So what that means is the bulb has resistance in it that allows the alternator to turn on. And if the bulb burns out, I have a resistor wire that is in this harness. Now, there are kits you can buy that are a resistor wire, but there's also kits that have a diode in them. And those kits that have a diode in them, well, they can be powered basically right off the back of the alternator. And the reason there's a diode in it is to make the current flow only in one direction, because you aren't using a keyed switch on that style with the diode. You're just running power to it. And so if you were to take and not have that diode in there and you shut your key off, well, that would still supply power in through that wire without the diode, and your distributor would still be powered up. So your vehicle wouldn't shut off. So what GM did later, because the early ones did have a diode in, they added a resistor wire and they fed it off the keyed power instead of the constant power. Hopefully that makes sense. All right, this comes down to it. Why do we care whether we use a single wire or whether we go back to the three wire? Well, let's just talk about a disadvantage, I guess, of the single wire. The one disadvantage, I guess, is if your vehicle sits for a long period of time, that single wire alternator, I've had experience where it kills the battery. You have to disconnect the battery. And if that's something that you are okay with, well, disconnect the battery and live with life. The other disadvantage is you can end up with an overcharge or an undercharge situation because they aren't actually, now this is debatable and I'd love for people to put it in the comments, but from what I understand, a lot of those voltage regulators are getting fed right from the source. And so when vehicles are at an idle, the headlights might be dim or they might be overcharging. So I don't know. Let's talk about that one. There is a big advantage to the single wire alternators. From what I understand, it's harder to get a three wire alternator with as big an amperage as you can with the updated single wire alternators. Now that brings me back to some of those big single wire single wire alternators. They supposedly can use the SI plug. Please let me know if you know anything about that one, because I don't have experience with that. When I get a big single wire, I put it on and I'm not worried about it. So the three wire now, well, the disadvantage is the wire color is not, might not be factory. You might want to change that if you're going for a factory look. The other thing is it's definitely more complicated wiring. And if you're taking an older vehicle, say with a voltage regulator, and you're updating it, you're probably going to be hacking the wiring harness up. And if you don't do a good job, or if you buy a vehicle that someone's put an SI alternator on, say a 60s vehicle, Chevy, what has that alternator on, you're probably going to get a wiring harness that has some hack to it. The nice thing about the three wire alternator though, is if you have a dash light, you're going to see it come on. And my experience with that is, I used to rock a Gremlin with a small block Chevy in it, and I would go down the racetrack and that thing buzzed to some high RPMs, and I would flip the belt off all the time. And I knew when my alternator light came on, it was brighter than my shift light, that I lost my alternator belt and that I got to shut it off at the end of the track, because by the time I get back to the pits, I'm going to be overheating. So anyway, I hope this helped you make some decisions on what kind of alternator that you want. And please, let's discuss, am I wrong somewhere? Is there a better option out there? Let me know what you think. And please like, share, and subscribe.